And welcome back to Gator Sniper playthrough of Metal Gear Rising Revengeance. Woo, let's go. I decided not to use the pincer blades, by the way, because it's fucking those guns suck. Not guns. I mean, you could argue that they're guns because, whew, Ryan, he is packing. He is packing the guns. God, they're throwing a lot of cows at me this early on. It's okay, I'm still uneasy. I'm never changing it again from, like, the hard to easy. I don't remember if it was last time I played this game where that was a problem, or maybe it was the time before last. I don't remember when it was actually still in hard mode. I think I'd already changed it by last time, but yeah, I'm never again am I going to claim to have skill at a thing. I mean, if I ever do seem to have skill at a thing, I'm probably going to say it's something like completely unbelievable. Like, you know, I'm really good at solving AIDS or whatever. You know, just normal stuff. Now, get overheat. Oh my god. You are the most advanced fucking machine in the world, and you're still being this much of a pain in my ass. I thought it was only my computer that could do that to me. I swear to god. Actually, you know what? I'm being harsh on my computer right now, but, no, it's a pretty good computer. It actually hasn't been messing up recently. It's, like, too terribly bad. Which, I mean, there's honestly no reason it should. I swear to god, if you fucking back away one more time, stop that. Stop it, robot. Fucking technology, can't trust it in this time period. But yeah, no, good computer. You haven't crashed recently. You've been doing other weird shit, but I'm okay. Sometimes you just gotta pick up, like, the more necessary evil. Okay, what's a comment I can say that actually has something to do to relate with this game? What did I even do last time? We killed Armstrong, we fell out of a helicopter, so Brian decided not to die that time. Fucking don't know what that's up. I don't even know why they fucking had it where I could. I mean, I know why they did it. They did it because, like, you fucking. Oh, hey, what are you? Oh, you're the hammer guy. They only did it because it was, the only reason they had it where you died there is because, like, they just don't. The game's not that open. Like I said, it's a straight line, so if you fall somewhere they don't want you to fall from, the only option they have is to make you die. You know, there's nothing else they can really do. It's just fucking. I just have the problem with the logical consistency. Now give me your heart, or whatever. I don't even know what this is. What is the purpose of the thing I'm stealing again? I vaguely remember electrolytes. Like, I'm grabbing the Gatorade sack. It's like that fucking movie Idiocracy. Everything has to do with Gatorade in this future society. Wait, hold on. Oh, fuck. There we go. Yeah. Give me your Gatorade sacks. Okay, what am I. I don't remember what Raiden. Why did I. I came back down to the city after falling from the helicopter. But what am I doing now? Like. Oh, escape from Denver. Perfect timing. Oh, that's also right. Yeah, we're trying to get to the other side of the world in, like, 30 seconds. Or no, 30 minutes. Is it really that slow? I've never been out of country. Like, I have no idea how long a plane ride is. I just. Maybe it was very naive of me, but I swear to god we could go faster than that. Well, I don't know. I don't know. There's also, I don't know if it's in this game or in something else, but no, I'm pretty sure it's in this game. They're saying something about, like, they're talking about the levels of Mach speed we had, and one of them, I swear, they were like, whatever level Mach speed they said they had in this future, it didn't match up in my head with what I thought I knew of, like, the Mach speed we had reached. Like, I thought we had gotten pretty fucking good and fast at Mach speed, and oh my god, if this music gets it, there we go. That was loud as fuck. But yeah, I thought we had, like, good Mach speed. What's our current top Mach speed? It's really interesting if I could ever get the fucking word out of my mouth. Whoa, Raiden! Nice Falcon kick. They need to fucking confirm you for Smash, I swear. Although, he's already in fucking PlayStation All-Stars. That's probably the last place he'll ever be if they. Unless they decide to just, like, cheap out, sell out, and make, fucking Metal Gear Rising 2. I don't even know if they could have it be about Raiden anymore. Like, is there really any purpose in following Raiden's story? Like, this game just. I feel like this game only came out just to show, like, this future where people are now cyborgs. Because Metal Gear Solid 4, Raiden was a cyborg. And I guess people were like, oh, what could that mean for the Metal Gear universe? you know, this game where originally this character played exactly like Solid Snake, like every other Metal Gear we know. Now he's a robot. How would he go about being like Metal Gear anymore? Or, I guess, like Snake anymore, because he's basically just like a human Metal Gear. And their answer was, let's make it nothing like Metal Gear. Yeah, fuck it. We'll just make it a hack and slash. I mean, in all honesty, it'd be kind of weird if they, I don't know. In ways I can argue, like, it would be neat if they had, like, the same principles of, like, you're sneaking around Metal Gear style as, like, a cyborg robot, but then in other ways it's like, oh yeah, that's the old formula, but then again, this is another formula. The only difference is it's not their, like, their own unique formula. This is a formula that's probably, for all intents and purposes, started by either, like, Devil May Cry or ye olden, like, arcade games. I don't know, I'd consider an arcade game a hack and slash, right? Like, you just go around, you hit your buttons, you have a light, you have a heavy attack. That's what I need to play. I need to play an old, arcade game again, just for, like, my own amusement. There's one I played before, I think it was Golden Axe, I'm not too sure. It's one where you played as the, you play it as a big muscular guy, you could play as like a dwarf, I guess, and you could play as, you could play as a girl. Oh god damn it, I fucked up. I didn't realize that laser sight was on me. But yeah, you played as a girl, and you could get some like crazy ass, like super awesome special moves, and there's like three different levels of it. One guy's power was earth, one was volcano, and the other was fire, and I was like, those are weirdly specific powers to have, like the power of volcanoes. You could just be like, you'd think that just fall under the category of fire, but I mean, I don't know, it is kind of unique. It's like a mix of earth and fire. That's nice. I like that. I've always liked the idea of like you got your basic like you're not like fucking you are interrupting my beautiful storytelling. You have like your like, I guess let's just for this experiment say five elements, like fire, water, wind, trees, nature, flowers, plants and animals, whatever. We'll call that nature. And then you could just have it like, oh, these all mix up and make weirdly neat things. It's basically fucking Pokemon. Like, you have a fucking weird-ass, like, shadow psychic Pokemon that everyone hates. Or because, like, dragon is apparently an element, you have to make a frickin' fairy-type Pokemon, which everyone's kind of upset with. But, you know, some of them are attractive and you could probably fuck it, so it's all good. Get over it, you fucking monkey. I have no time for you. You hug me. Don't hug me. Don't... Oh, hey, that was actually easy to break out of. I honestly thought it'd take longer to break out of that. I don't know. I should have just fucking ran from this damn monkey. That's what I should have done, but I didn't. It's just, I don't know. I'm getting too used to how hard I can hit. I hit so fucking hard that it's like, oh yeah, I could break this guy before he can cause me slight frustration. And I swear to God, the fucking robot monkeys, all they do is cause frustration. Oh, this is so cool, but I can't reach that last guy. Well then. This was completely pointless, and there's literally no reason I should have done that. Oh, whoa. I, like, shaved that guy's fucking head. Anyone else see that guy? I just, like, barely cut the side of his, like, skull and neck off. Oh, god. Now I'm thinking of body shaving. Or, okay, flaying. That's probably a better word than fucking body shaving. Body shaving. The new thing. Hello. Were you there taking a piss? There you go. Now you're dead, I can assume. I think you're dead. Here, do you have an arm I could take? No? Well, let me cut it off anyways. Let me actually just make your life hell. Oh, I can't do anymore. Well, then. Okay. When does this level end? Have I escaped Denver yet? Am I back at the beginning? Do I just have to fucking get back in my old car? I don't even know why I fucking bother trying to ask these questions. I've beaten this game before. I know exactly what it is I'm trying to do. I'm just trying to sound neat. You see that motorcycle that showed up for a little bit before I jumped over that now completely gone fence? Yeah, motorcycle. Have I? I don't... There's no way you would have escaped a, like, pursuit of that level. Or, I guess, whatever level they deem for you. There's no way you would have escaped that quickly. No freaking way. Hello? That's a motorcycle. You're just gonna steal someone's fucking motorcycle ride? What an asshole. Aren't you gonna lecture people about, like, the government stealing shit?
So I'll just steal this from another civilian, whatever.
What did he write? He says, I need your bike for your... thank you for your cooperation. And what is that? 111555. Thanks, Ryan. You put something down that no one understands. There we go. Hey, another level done. And just like I feared in the last episode, now I'm going to be in a fucking weird place where, like, I have to end, like, a halfway point each episode. Good news, though, is I'm nearly done with this game, I think. I have one boss fight to do. No, do not customize Ryan's body. I have one boss fight to do and one level, or, like, half a level, and then another boss fight. It's all good. It's all good in this hood. God, Ryan, could you be any more metal? You're just, like, the coolest person I know. Can you, like, sign my boobs? They're a bit hairy, but I think you could work a pen around them. Nah, you're too cool for me, aren't you? Just riding around on your, what is that? Is that a lowrider? What do you call it when, like, the fucking wheel's way too far from the rest of the body? What? Oh, that guy. Yeah, doctor's fine. He's just flying around in his semi-auto helicopter being a lame-o. What happened to Wolf? Is he following behind me? Or are we just like, nah, he'll fucking find his own way back home? Seriously, Wolf, where are you? Oh no, Ryan's stopping, for whatever reason. Suck if he just ran out of gas. Oh, no, even worse. There's a... what is that? Oh, it's Wolf. Oh, how did you get ahead of me? Maybe you actually were telling me that in that dialogue. I was like, going, you slut! You're sleeping with Jetstream Sam! It's okay, they're good friends. Are you gonna betray me now, Wolf? Am I gonna have to kill you? Nah, you're a good pup, I know. You would never betray me. Still a slut, though. Yeah, he sounds like that kind of shifty-eyed motherfucker. What do you want, you weirdo? I like how he carries a sword a lot more than how Ryan does. Oh yeah, what a fucking coincidence. Not like you just fucking camped out in the road waiting for me. Oh. I guess that is a good thing to thank him for.
Well, not if you say it like that.
Don't be a dick, Sam. Says the guy missing an eye, an arm, fucking all of his pride. Oh no! Not money! Oh, well apparently it isn't the money.
I'm talking ideals.
Yeah, Ryden, what are your ideals? Do you actually follow anything or are you just a worthless piece of shit? That's what I like about this game. The main character is really unlikable. That, like, seriously, that's a good thing to like about this. It's like, oh, he's not right. He's a moron who doesn't understand the whole fucking story. But you know what's kind of good? He kind of learns to, like, know the whole story. Not gonna really argue that because fucking he's still such a fucking shitty personality. I just don't like Ryde. I still like how he doesn't know. He's not the right person. I don't know. I don't even know how to fucking explain myself. I leave, like, really good explaining to other videos. Oh, what are you complimenting me for? My ass? I gotta say, it's pretty flat. I see yours is flat, too. How about we combine our asses into one big ass? We'll look really sexy. We'll get all the girls. Or I'll get all the girls. You know what? I'm just gonna kill you, take your ass, and eat it to gain your ass powers. Or I could just eat your heart and gain your cyborg powers. Although, no, you know what, I'm gonna leave that bit, I'm gonna let that bit play itself out. I won't spoil that. Oddly enough, I don't remember this fight all that well. I remember, like, the plot points of the fight, but I don't remember the fight itself too well. Like, oh, you're protecting your mouth? What is everyone in protecting their lower jaw in this game? Fucking weird. Okay, yeah, just you and me, I got this. Come on, come at me, bro, I got you. Got you ready. Huh? Yeah? Got you ready. What am I saying? Here, you know what? Fucking... oh, God! I thought he would want to look at that. Oh, God. Oh, God. Yeah, I do not remember this fight all too well. Like, actually sword fighting him. Of course, it's going to be really easy because I'm high level and kind of cheating, but whatever, it's fine. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah. Wow, this is really easy. Once you... well, okay. Before I say this, it helps that I have auto assist on, but once you understand the blocking mechanic of this game, very easy to just go through a fight without getting hurt at all, as long as you're paying attention and actually aiming in the right direction. Whoop. But yeah, with my fucking auto assist parry, it's way too easy. I don't know, I'm thinking about playing on easy and also turning the auto parry off. Oh, look at that, I took damage. Although, it's literally way too fucking late at this point. Like, I've already practically beaten the game. Oh, look at that. I'm gonna cut your arm off, boy. Wait. Oh, I thought I actually cut his arm off. I was like, whoa, no way, really? I really don't remember this fight. Show you a good time? Oh, alright, well. You're gonna use your fucking hands? Dude, you're way cooler than I could ever be. I like Jetstream Sam. He's a cool character. He's a badass. He's like, I don't know. What'd you call him? Oh. He's just like your normal... He's a mentor figure. He's a great mentor figure for Raiden. Even though it's kind of like... I don't know. He's definitely trying to kill him. They're enemies, but he... Oh, God. They're en... Jetstream Stam's a weird guy, if I could ever pronounce his name correctly. He's a bad guy, but... You know what? He's also... He's free. He's free like the wind. He'll always, always be... doing whatever the fuck he wants to, such as teaching Raiden how to be a fucking good character. Okay, you are very annoying, sir. You mind not doing that Chidori rush at me ever again? But honestly, it doesn't really matter since I can just block it like that. Oh my god. Okay, come on. Will you stop and let me hit you? Oh my, you know what? I don't have anything to throw at him. Awesome. Can I just hit you? Am I doing something wrong here? I wonder if I'm supposed to... Oh, I bet I'm supposed to, like, actually parry that attack and, use that to... Whoop. No? Maybe not. Well, I mean, is it just too heavy of an attack to parry? Or am I parrying too early? Am I doing something... No? Ugh, I don't know. Come on, what... Oh, wait, maybe I just need to ninja run. Yeah, oh, shit, I should've just been ninja running. Yeah, I forgot a bit of the controls, it's all good. Whoop. You're so obnoxious, boy. There we go, there's some progress. I'm gonna cut you right through you. That's a terrible idea, by the way. No one ever tried to catch a sword. It's probably impossible for fucking people. Unless they were wearing, like, gauntlets. And, I don't know. The two-handed stop is kind of a really bad idea, but, I don't know. With one hand, if it's well-protected, maybe you could stop a sword. I don't fucking know. I don't know swordplay. Oh, but that does bring up an interesting story. There was, it's like the best Japanese swordsman of our day was pitted against a robot that was based off of him. It's not like a really cool robot, it's not like a humanoid robot, it's just like a fucking... It's like a crane that holds onto a sword. And, it was like based off of, it was based off of him, like, all of its, like, skill level, for lack of a better word. And, Man, you're being very obnoxious, Jetstream Sam. They did a little tournament between the two. And the robot won, which is very scary. But that fucking robot has computer precision technology. I mean, it'd be cooler if the dude won, but you know, there's not much you can really do against a robot. I mean, they're basically designed to be better than people. Oh, let me get your arm, by the way. Can I just cut your arm off, please? Don't worry, it's fine. It's all decided by cutscene anyways. There we go. Yeah, that's not as... Maybe that's why I just didn't remember the fight. It's just not really an interesting fight. Maybe if I upped the difficulty, it'd be more fun, but... I don't know, that just wasn't, like, not much really of interest happened. It wasn't even that thrilling of, like, a sword fight. I don't know, maybe... For one, I don't know, I shouldn't be bitching about it when I'm playing with, like, auto-parry and on easy mode. Did you just wink at that dog? You are a weirdo, sir. That is a robot dog. How you doing, buddy? You bleeding out over there? It's all good. I believe in you. Yeah, there you go. Good job, Raiden. You actually did it right for once. Well, I mean, I don't know why I'm saying for once. You've been winning against all these guys. Yes, he is. Good observation, doggy. Yeah, that is the coolest part about Sam. I think the only enhancement he has is his arm. Although, I don't know, he might have, like, some nanomachine stuff or whatever. But yeah, he doesn't have all the fucking cyborg enhancements like Raiden does. And you know why that's cool? Because he still kicked my ass. Ah, you hear that? Dog is dropping wisdom. Good dog. Oh, interessant. Yeah? Yeah, that's some good life advice. Are you going to use this? Oh, yeah, that's right. I can't use it. Can you use, like... Oh, okay, that's... Okay, yeah, you should have just translated it to English the first time. So the sword... Oh, good dog. So that sword was the sword he got from his dad, which... makes me still not understand what ethnicity Jetstream Sam was. I mean, you don't really have to be Japanese to own a katana, but whatever katana it was, is apparently a really goodly crafted one. Ryan, don't you dare touch it. You son of a bitch, you're ruining it with your false ideals. Ideals? Why did I say it all weird? Ideals! Should really keep track of my words better. Alright, dog, you hold on to this. I don't know where you're gonna keep it besides your mouth, but, you know, it's not gonna bother you, right? Yeah, seriously, stop fucking around with dead people. Yeah. Well then, there they go, running off into the sunset, all beautiful like. Yay! Wow, these levels towards the end got really short. Debating. I'm trying to decide if I want to end this episode here, because I don't remember exactly how long the next part is. Because I'm remembering, like, the final fight, and it's a pretty big final fight. You know, I'm just going to keep going for a little bit. I'll go for another 10 minutes and, yeah, see how that turns out. I don't know if the fight's going to comprise of, like, a whole 30 minutes, but, I'll stop before then. That's all good. Yeah, so yay, more stuff. We get to see Sunny, who's a character from, well, not really. She's, like, indirectly a character from Metal Gear Solid 2. It's a hairy armpit lady's, child, I think. No, this isn't the first time you meet her. There's another game where you meet her. Oh, pizza. That sounds so good right now. Like a really good vegetable pizza. Oh, God. Oh, he's a freaking weeaboo. So am I. I understand that. I wonder if these are actual mangas. Oh. So kawaii. Oh, my God. That's so sad. I mean, it's not really sad. Okay, you know, it's pretty sad. So kawaii. Aw. Wait, who's... That's not Wolf, is it? What happened to his head? Oh, there it is. Okay, yeah, that's Wolf. Yeah, asshole. Fucking pay attention to your job next time. So I can actually get in here easier. Quit reading your fucking weeaboo manga. Yeah, you better. Ah, oh, Sunny. She's adorable. She is also extremely underage. She looks like a fucking Final Fantasy character. Yeah, aw, oh, she's so adorable. Don't call me stranger. Don't be a fucking weirdo, Ryan.
Aww, who's your little friend?
That is a dog, not a friend. No, oh, I'm sure it is, Ryan. No! Bite! Oh, really? You are a terrible person. You support my argument, good sir. Really? You're gonna go into murderous Jack the Ripper mode because your dog wouldn't shake your hand? This game is really anime. I like that. Like, that right there is totally an anime thing. I'd say this game is very Japanese. I don't know how that translates well, but it's, like, the feeling I get about it is, it has a lot of the Japanese comedy aspects. I don't distinctly remember if the Metal Gear Solid games had that aspect, like, but that thing where, like, the red aura appeared when he was angry, that's totally a fucking Japanese comedy thing. Yeah. I mean, sure, they use a lot in anime, but it's also, like, Japanese comedy thing. Really, I could not be less interested. I guess I am. Because she looks like my kid with her hair. Seriously, did Olga... I guess Olga did have, not normal colored hair. I'm having a hard time remembering. All I can remember about Olga, her fucking armpits. Just really saying something about her. I don't know. It's you look at her and you're like, oh, wow, she is totally a beautiful character, but then you just look at her armpits and you're like, what? Which is such a terrible thing. I don't know, it's just fucking body hair. I don't know. Society I grew up in, man. The only good thing is I can question it, man. Maybe we shouldn't fucking... I don't fucking know what I'm even trying to say anymore. I just make sure if I ever sound like I'm getting, like, really idealistic to add a barfing noise at the end of it, so I have some self-deprecation in there. I did. That does not look like something I would take just to go all the way to the other side of the world. Wait, are we going to Afghanistan? Oh, just like in Phantom Pain... Will I find a memento of, oh, you're really still doing that, buddy? You are such a nerd. Fucking weeaboo. Oh, God. He must have found, like, the fucking centerfold. That's such a weird way to end that on. I love this. I love this game. Despite all the times I sound like I don't. Oh, Pakistan, not Afghanistan. Damn, I was really hoping it would be like, hey, there's a memento from Big Boss. Unless, oh god, I'm having a geography crisis. Pakistan, Afghanistan, where are they relevant to each other? Please tell me one's not actually within the other one. I'd feel really stupid if that were the case. Alright, come on, dog, we're going. Got 5 minutes to play around in this airfield. Yeah, that's about right. What do you gotta say, buddy? Kevin.
Nothing. You sure we got the right place?
No. No. We fucking... No. Yeah, no. Yeah, it's not like the president isn't fucking scheduled to be here. Oh, wait, that's right. This is a private thing, isn't it? I thought it was like a more public thing. Okay, so yeah, maybe we could have it wrong. Who knows? Yay! God, I wish I had a robot body. Just to, like, do cool things in. I'd probably misuse it at one time or another, but it'd be so cool. Alright, dog, lead me. Lead me forward. I wonder if I should attempt to sneak in through here. I mean, dog isn't. Bad dog. Oh, those enemies gonna notice me? No. I don't even know if that truck really had anything to, like... I don't think that truck would have spotted me or anything. There's people here. Should I try to... I don't know. I think I'm gonna try sneak in. Let's see if I can. Whoop. Bum bum ba, bum ba da da da. Oh, I have to break through the gate anyways. Oh, eliminate all enemies. Okay, then I guess I really don't have to... I guess I don't have to sneak in. Oh, thanks. I guess I had no choice in, like, sneaking in the first place anyways. Did anyone else hear that really weird scream, by the way? I caught, a glimpse of it in my ears, but... I don't know if I was just hearing things. I oftentimes hear the screams of the damned within me. Woo! God. I want Raiden's sword, too. While we're at the subject of, like, having his body, I want his sword. It'd be so fucking awesome. I don't know. I like the tactical blades. I used to like the, normal katanas and, European swords more, but... I don't know, tactical blades have got that, like... They've got their own, like... They're like the new sword. It's cool. I mean... I'm not saying that, like... Oh, God! That guy's body was horrifying. I'm not saying that, like how people look at, like, new iPhones. Like, I want it because it's new! I'm looking at, like, oh, that's a step in history. Courtney. Wait, who's... Oh, Courtney, the girl. Yeah, that girl. The girl that literally doesn't have anything to do with this game. Uh-huh. Can you talk when I don't need to break a gate down?
It's their alibi.
Sure it is, Red.
It's a conspiracy! I watch the X-Files!
Uh-huh. That's a big fucking jump.
Not when they've got this nice big foreign threat all cooked up and ready to serve.
Uh-huh.
The media and the public won't be able to resist. Remember WMD?
I don't even know what a WMD is!
You're right. It's another slam dunk!
Why did you put never mind. I know why they put fucking quotation marks around it.
Or brain-jacked.
Brain-jacked? You can do that? Or do you have to have, like, a computer brain for that to work? Huh. Weird. Oh, there's a good book I read. What was it? I think it's called A Confusion of Princes. It's, like, set in, like, the super, super far future. And there's these princes that are in line to rule the universe... But it's not like some family of princes, they're just like genetically superior people of each species that they just pick up and as like children. And they would give them like the most advanced technologies like in their body. And the three divisions of it were like Sci-Tech, Tech-Tech, and Biotech. One's like, they gave them like advanced biology, like muscles and stuff. There's also advanced, like, they had, like, technology built into them. They also had, what was the last thing? They had psychic abilities, too, which is, like, a weird blue fluid that they'd, like, spill through their brains. It was all really cool, and I loved it. It's a good book. I want to read it again. And ram you through the ass. That is my dick. That is a representation of my dick. Going right up your bum. One more person. Hey, oh, what? You weren't even looking at me. Fucking, these robots really have their peripheral vision, unlike the... Unlike the soldiers from Metal Gear Phantom Pain back in the 80s, which I can only assume was like 30, 40 years ago relative to this game. I need back my health. That fucking 10% health that I like to hold on to. And where's everybody? Was that really it? Was that everybody? Oh, there's a camera. That's what that was. Well, okay, just like I promised, 3, 2, 1, and 30 minutes on my timer. So, I'm going to end the episode here. This has been a Gator Sniper playthrough. See you guys in the next one. Later, everybody.